and a vote of 321 to 101, the House voted to pass the COPE bill, the Communications Opportunity Promotion and Enhancement Act. This controversial telecommunications legislation would permit phone and cable companies to operate internet and other digital communication services, private networks, free of policy safeguards or government oversight. The bill effectively ends what's known as net neutrality, which is the concept that everyone, everywhere should have free, universal, and non-discriminatory access to the internet. Democratic Massachusetts Congress member Ed Markey had proposed an amendment to the COPE bill that would have included stiff net neutrality regulations and prevented broadband providers from treating some internet sites differently from others, but the amendment was rejected. This is Congressman Markey speaking from the House floor yesterday.
Let me just make this point once again. The Bell companies had nothing to do with the creation of the internet. The Bell companies had nothing to do with the development of the World Wide Web. The Bell companies had nothing to do with the browser and its development. But now, at this late date, they want to come in and to create these bottleneck control points that allow them to extract internet taxes, internet fees from companies and individuals who have been using the internet for a generation. It is this absence of non-discriminatory language in the manager's amendment and in the bill to which I object.
Opposition to the COPE bill came from all corners. The Save the Internet Coalition, representing musicians, special interest groups, bloggers, and others, delivered almost 800,000 petition signatures to Congress in favor of net neutrality. We're joined now in the studio by Anthony Riddle. He's the executive director of the Alliance for Community Media. Welcome to Democracy Now!
Good morning, Amy.
So, is net neutrality over?
No, I'd say that we're halfway to the apocalypse right now. There's been a fairly bad bill for the internet and for public media that has gone through the House. It's the COPE Act, and effectively, it changed the internet fundamentally. Before that time, it was understood that all data on the internet was to be treated equally and that nobody was to block any information going from anyone to anyone. With the Supreme Court decision and last night's bill, the companies that operate the wires or fibers that bring the internet to and from your house have the ability to offer preferential treatment for pay and also to block any content that they deem opposing their business interests.
So users already pay internet service per month. So this does the other end, the content providers. People who put up websites would also have to pay?
No, they actually pay already now. You know, if you have a website, you have to pay for space on the website, and you have to pay for a pipeline for people to reach it, and however big that pipeline is for people to come to your website, that determines how many people can access your web streams or whatever. So people are paying on both ends already. What they're trying to do right now is get people to pay for the middle, so that you can pay for an easy pass lane if you're Disney and you have a lot of money, and if you don't, then you're going to have to sit in the long lines waiting to go through the toll booth.
Well, wasn't it Mike McCurry, the former spokesperson for President Clinton, who really was the front man, the spokesperson for the key lobbyist for a kind of AstroTurf campaign where progressive bloggers had ads on their websites that said, stop government interference or regulation of the internet?
This is you're right, and this is like 1984. If they're saying stop government interference, what they really mean is we want interference. It's just like the Clean Air Act.
Corporate interference.
Yeah. Well, it's been amazing. You know, I've known how the government ran for a long time, but I never really understood the power of money. Over on the Hill, Verizon had over 200 lobbyists just on this bill. You know, and that's not even talking about AT&T. They've bought every single person that can work on anything. I think people really need to be up in arms
when
about
does
this.
The
We've even got the Christian Coalition and the NRA involved in this because everybody understands that if you have anything that's remotely not mainstream, that this can be blocked if these measures go through. This is what I hope. What I hope is that the people who are within the range of this program and all over the United States will check in on this matter.